Good afternoon to viewers, the Colonel speaking to you live from the Grange, a British Imperial YouTube broadcasting. Now we've got a sort of recitation now. How Bill Adams won the Battle of Waterloo, sung by Dick Darby. On a Zono phone record, here we go.
How Bill Adams won the Battle of Waterloo. Well, you know, chap, it was like you see at Waterloo. There was me and the Duke and the rest of it. We was a standing round there with our staff, and the Duke, he'd only got about 150 men available, and in front of his couple of glasses, he seen Bonaparte coming over the hill with 400,000 picked men. He didn't like the look of it at all, and he turns around to Sir Garnet Wolsey, and he says, Garnet, this here's a tough job as we've got to cut out, he says. Who's going to take this here job on, are you? Not me, says Garnet. But he says, it's all right, Governor, he says. Here's a Nelson coming up. Just that minute, Nelson, he come a-galloping up on his white horse, and he kicked off his horse and saluted the Duke, and a-shoving his wooden leg in the ground, and you know Nelson had a wooden leg, what he lost it, and, Lord bless my soul, now where was it he lost that leg? I was with him when he rattled it, too. Oh, to ring at the cam, of course it was. A Duke, he turns around to Nelson, and he says, Horatio, we've only got about 100 men available, and there's Bonaparte here coming over the hill with 784,000 men. Picked men, most of them. You take on the job? No, it ain't hardly in my line, he says. There's only one man as can take this here job on. Who indeed, says the Duke. Who's that? Why, he says, Bill Adams. Well, of course, the Duke says, what old juggies I must have been up to a thought of Bill. Of course, Bill is the man for this here job, and he whistles me up. I was just round the canteen, having half a cup of tea. He says, here, William, I want you. Well, I goes up, and I says, well, nosy, what is it? He says, William, I'm in a bit of a hole. We've only got about 80 men available, and here's Bonaparte, he says, coming over the hill with 785,000 men. Can you take this here job on? Well, I says, yes, Arthur, I says, I think I can pull you through. How many men was you thinking of giving me? Well, he says, you pick what you want, William. I picked about 60 of them, and I know what they could do. And we goes a marching up the hill. And just as I got to the top, and I was going to wipe out that Bonaparte and his little lot, I looked around the corner, and I see Bonaparte, Blucher and Napoleon are hiding behind a tree. And Bonaparte and Napoleon was a-laughing at our little lot a-coming up against his army. But old Blucher, he looks around the other side of a tree, and he see me, and he knows me, and he turns as white as a sheet. He says, you're a-laughing at them, gentlemen, ain't you? There ain't many of them. But he says, you see who it is a-leading of these here men? No, Bonaparte, he says, I can't see as I know thee. Anybody to be frightened of? Anybody to be frightened of? Don't you go and do nothing rash, he says. That there's Bill Adams. What, he says? Is that Bill Adams the leading of them? Holy smoke, he says. Then the game cuts, he says. That's the cove for giving such pepper at Ballyclava. He turns round to his army and he says, right about face. Get all the grass, he says, if you don't want to be heat up. Here's Bill Adams a-coming. And that's the way me and the Duke won the Battle of Waterloo, boys.
Well, there you go, viewers. As the Duke also said, if you'll believe that, you'll believe anything. Thank you, viewers, and goodbye.